The challenge for this STEM project was to create a hibernation habitat for an animal. In this case, our animal is a bat. In our bat's habitat, we had to provide protection from harsh winter weather and predators.
Explore and research. As a group, we all did some research and read that bats can be found in caves above ground and underground. They can also appear in your homes, such as ceilings of your garage or inside your vents. We also found out that bats hawks, owls, snakes, and weasels.
The brainstorm. We all agreed on making a cave. We all discussed on the materials we would bring. Adam suggested sticks and straws. I thought the toilet paper rolls would be a great idea and pipe cleaners. Felix mentioned a newspaper and string. Yesenia wanted to bring cardboard and the hot glue gun. We all agreed on making Yesenia's and Felix's design. We figured we would shape the cave with cardboard and cover it with brown paper, then to somehow make the bat hang.
As you can see on that corner, that's Nicole's, and then the one on the bottom is Adam's. This top one is mine, and then the one on the bottom is Felix's.
Materials. The materials we used for this project were cardboard, brown paper, black string, a hot glue gun, and silicone sticks. A toilet paper roll, brass prongs, thumbtacks, and pipe cleaners.
The cardboard, the toilet paper rolls,
the black string, and the pipe cleaners,
and the brass prongs.
Constructing. We first decided to shape our cave with some cardboard the teacher gave us. We cut it in four pieces, two large ones and two more smaller ones. We connected one of the smaller pieces of cardboard with a larger one at an angle. Then we did the same thing to the two other pieces and connected both of them like a pentagon shape. Next, we cut off about 1/4 of a toilet paper roll and added a top to it. Once that dried, we put a brass prong through the inside of the toilet paper roll. Next, we tied string around the two prongs sticking out and cut it about 1 foot long.
We then put the end of the string through a little gap in the roof. Afterwards, we added some wrinkled brown paper over the cave to give it more of a rocky look. We figured that putting a ball of brown paper could look like a huge rock in the entrance. To make the bat more realistic, Nicole added some black felt around the roll, some googly eyes, and she cut out wings with cardboard, then added black felt over it. In addition, we glued the cave to a cardboard box. Finally, to keep the bat even safer, we added a mini cave to surround our bat and added some stalactites with pipe cleaners.
In conclusion, our cave protects the bat from harsh winter weather and predators. The mini cave protects the bat from incoming precipitation, and the paper over the wall camouflages it. The camouflage helps if a predator comes, they won't really notice the mini cave. Where the bat is sleeping, there are stalactites which may block the bat or distract the predators. This is the bat cave.
As you can see,
the little bat is in their bat.
This is our bat.
This is the bat. I cut out some cardboard shaped like wings, and then I put some felt in it so that it can look all black, and then I put some googly eyes. So, this is the string that we put for the bat, and this is how it would look.
Pull it up, and then it flies up.
Whoa. That's awesome.
And we open it just so y'all can look
at
it.
Absorb the bat.
These are are the stalactites to protect the bats. And
this is this brown paper represents the really big boulder covering the cave to protect it from weather.
And then also the mini cave, if it's harsh like winter weather, such as like precipitation or wind, it'll block it. And any other predators that could camouflage. That's our back.
What is the problem? The problem is that we had to plan how are we going to set the house so the box turtle can hibernate. And we needed to check if the animal can get in and out of his shell.
Explore and research the problem. Explain animals sleep for a long time. This kind of animal that do not hibernate is because they
brainstorm and design a solution to the problem. We started to tell what we could bring for the project. The problem was that we couldn't find out how to sketch it. So then we started to look and we started to design.
Build, test, and analyze your solution. We used cardboard, toilet tubes, glue, and construction paper. Cotton and hot glue. The cotton is going to represent the snow. The construction is a shelter for the turtle.
Improve or redesign and retest the solution. We first did like a cave, but it did not work. So we did a box and it did work. We first put marshmallows, then we took out and put them with white paper and put cotton.
So then,
this is the hibernating house of the box turtle. The cotton represents the snow. We put toilet tips around the snow, and then we covered it with construction paper. Then we put fake snow, so we put the fake snow. Then we glued on a cup to the bottom, so the turtle can get down and to be more safe below the ground. So when the predators come in, they will not know that the turtle is on the below the ground.
A hibernating house by
Mariana Conde,
Claudia Hernandez,
Victor Flores,
y Viviana López.
Research the problem. The problem of this hibernating house is that we have to know first what is hibernation. Why do some animals hibernate? Also, what features must be present in the place where an animal hibernates? This is all the question that we have to answer in a group. Then we have to add the results about the questions. The first question is, what is hibernation? Hibernate is when an animal sleeps for the rest of winter until spring, but they have to stay in a warm place and save energy. The next question is, why do some animals hibernate? They hibernate because they have to conserve energy when food is scarce. The next question is, what features must be present in the place where an animal hibernates? When they are hibernating, they need to have food and warm weather to survive the whole winter.
In our team, we first start to answer the question to know more better of how we are going to build the home. Then we solve the problem with that question. This second thing is that we did was to brainstorm what our animal we were going to do. Then we decide the groundhog. Then we start to think how we were going to build our home. We came up to do a burrow for the groundhog, which is where they live. Then we start to build the hibernation home on the top of our brain was going to present the floor of the habitat which the home, which the groundhog lives. We put pine cones to represent trees and columns to represent snow. Then we did like a tunnel on the bottom of the first floor, his bed and food. We had camouflage to the burrow to protect him from predators.
Bill and Tess analyzed your solution. We were thinking of doing our home as burrow, but we find out that we will do better with other materials like fake snow and a bed. We also think that for the house we could have a little space to represent the food and water, so the animal can have during the hibernation process. We also made a camouflage on the burrow so when the predators come, they will know where he was. When we're finished with the project, we think that an animal was safe on the hibernation of, and we will have better the project. We were trying to find a new solution of making the clock.
Improve or design and reset the solution. Our winter home did pick our animal and had enough space to make this winter home. Protects our ground from server weather because he is on the ground and he will cover it with more to be warm. Our winter home does perfect it a little bit from the temperatures, but mostly protects himself. With this short gloves, this winter home has a little ramp for him to go up the bowl for the present ramp that he made out of wood.
Present and share your resolution. I think we could have made our home for our groundhog a little bit better. But this home is very excellent for the groundhog. We could have made it better by making his home a little bit bigger. We could have set traps that the groundhog knew about and could do for the predators. We could also camouflage the burrow so the predator could completely not know about it. I could have added my solution to make it more awesome, and the groundhog would not worry about things during his hibernation. This is how it's the house of the groundhogs.
There's
his sleeping.
A little hall.
There's the hole that he's gonna go through. And
going to his home. Here represents the food and water he's going to have during his hibernation. This is a little home. And this is the top of the
ground.
The ground.
This is like the represent the trees, the snow, and
the bushes.
And that's it.
And that's it.
American blackbirds are omnivores. They eat plants, fruit, nuts, insects, honey, salmon, small mammals, and other things. Adult bear predator. The American black bear is 3 bears feet. Found in the North America and are found only in North America. Black bears are short, not
retractable.
Retractable claw that gives them an excellent tree climbing ability. The baby black bear has a lot of predators, and they are often collected, called humans and other bears. Cover, and then this is like a other rock that protects the bear from predators. So, and this is for like large predators. So the baby black bear has like large predators. So this is like they cannot get in because they're large. So, and here is the little black bear.
So, the bears, they can go on like here.